folks, Brian here. So this is part three of my camera crawler build. Please be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you enjoy these kinds of videos. Also, be sure to check out the playlist, and in the description there will be links to the items that are used, such as the kit and the tools. So here we go. So this is part three. We're going to build the axles. And oh, not axles, the shocks. And there are a whole crap ton of little parts in here and some oil. And again, I can't say enough good things about the way this is kitted. It certainly makes it easier when they kit everything properly. And some nice 35 weight oil. And then parts. Yep, so we're gonna need all these. Lots of little parts. Green and orange springs, and then a whole bunch of hardware. And there's some little circlips in here, so just make sure you get them all. Sure would have been nice if all these little things came put together, but whatever. Alright, so let's figure out what we're dealing with. So these are all the same. Some of them go inside. All right. I'm guessing those are the O-rings. There's my four O-rings. Two, four, five, six, seven. Just got one more of these bad boys. There's eight. My E-clips. Eight of these. Good luck picking them up. All right, so what does this look like? So these are hard to pick up. I'm not going to even remotely pretend that these are going to be easy to mess with. They're not. But this looks like the first thing that needs to happen. And you want to use a pair of pliers on these, and then watch that they don't flip off into outer space. Alright, so there's one. And then we need these little bracket thingies here. And then we put another little clip on. Wow. This doubles as a dexterity test. Yeah, I'll be right back. Alright, so I've got a very tiny pair of tweezers that are great for doing embroidery and sewing, and apparently they're great for installing these little clips. Eh, maybe not. I really don't have any easy answers on these clips. Let's see if... There we go. So there's one. Wow, what a pain in the ass. Yeah, I don't even know if you had a vise you could really do anything with this. These are just difficult to work with due to size. So you need to position it like this, and then just balance it. Does go, try again. And sometimes they're not going to stay, so then you gotta bend it a little bit, and these are so tiny. Alright, there's two. I'm gonna bring the camera down so you guys can see what I'm doing. Okay, so I'm just looking for the other two to keep track of them. All right. So basically what you got to do is you got to pick it up first. And then you got to grab it by the edge. All right. And then you got to set up for it. To come in here and you want to grab this at an angle. If it doesn't work, just repeat the whole process. That little snap is what you're looking for to tell you that you're in. Then you want to drop this on top. And it helps to hold it at an angle. There you go. So we'll do one more. Beginning to make this look like I might actually be quick at it. So when you get into these little itty bitty tiny parts, they will stick to your fingers just by surface tension. And yeah, my hands shake, among other things. There we go, and we bent it slightly, so we'll unbend it with the pliers. There we go, hopefully we didn't do too much damage to it and it doesn't leak too much. All right, deep breath. Because, yeah, that's a pain in the ass. So now what we need to do is push this all the way through. Small parts. So this goes in here, and then this goes on top of it like this. All right, so we'll just stop that like that. And we'll repeat and use up little tiny parts. I'm putting my crawler together. I'm doing it on YouTube, by the way, so. Some of these are much looser than others. I do not have high hopes for it being leak-proof. Requires an O-ring on top. Well, that should be interesting. It's not the best mechanical arrangement that I've ever seen. So what's going to hold that down? Oh, okay, I see. That's just a damper. All right, so we've got these assembled. They pull all the way out like this. And then each of them gets one of these that is put together like this. This is another really good thing for pliers. So basically you stick this in here like this and grab one side and just pop. So those are together. And then each of these gets put together like this. Try this a different way. some things don't seem to change in this industry, and this is a crappy assembly right here. So we're going to use these to stabilize it. And it's still crooked. And then we're just gonna twist it together and see what happens. I suspect an axle upgrade or a shock upgrade will be in order. There's not really a good way to do this. Okay, there is not a good way to do this. Just can't get it to start. So I think we're going to cheat. Let's just look and make sure. Nope, that's not threaded. If that was threaded, that would have solved my problem. Or if that had a driver on it. Thank you. just not a good way to get these started. So this is the curse of the plastic. Of course that'll work. Like, of course not. Yeah, the issue is there's no way. This is smooth and it turns, and this is not indented, so we're going to make it indented. Just enough to get it started. This is very, very difficult. This is just an asinine design right here. Because these are just exactly the size of the inside of the thread, so it cuts threads as it goes in, but there's no way to force it to go in. There's no way. This is crazy. So what I'm doing is reaming it with the other screwdriver so I can get it in here and get it started. That works. It still goes in crooked, but alright, so that is the magic solution. Alright, so we figured that one out. So what you do is slide this over one of these. In this case, I'm using a 2 millimeter. And then you come in with a 2.5 millimeter and you just bore this out. You really want this to be as straight as possible, so. Okay, so the depth of this bit is enough to get this started, and then that lets you put this in there, and that's how it should have been manufactured, so that you had a little lip to start with. And that's just somebody who designed this hasn't had to put it together by hand with limited tools. Whew, what a pain in the ass. All right, so now we got to coax O-rings in. Oh yeah, they don't go there. So we got to pull this all the way down. These go. Here. That's still coaxing it. But it's not as bad. It'll actually fit in there. So, we need to put these together. No, I think that waits. All right, so, maybe what we're going to do, we're going to pull this out. Some place to set this. Okay. And then we're going to raise this slowly up. No, it shouldn't matter. And then we're going to plug it. Set up for it. Well, that's disconcerting. There's an extra one of those little E-ring things. Okay, and then these go in here. And this should be reasonably easy. Famous last words. So what you want to do is hook the top of that so you want to hook this thing you can do is sandwich the metal piece like this and then just slide the so you one on each side and then you just pull it over. Okay, so now we're to the fun part where we get to put the springs on. So we have green and red, and we have no idea what the two do. First, we have to get them apart. So the green is stiffer and the red is softer, and we want a softer rod on this. So we'll put this over here. Then we gotta figure out how this goes together. Oh, like that. Alright, that's easy. Zero faith that it won't leak.
close to the back.
Okay, so thanks for watching. That was an exciting 48 minutes. Please remember to like and subscribe. I hope that helps some of you guys out.